Thanks for checking out Symphony on YouTube. Please be sure to subscribe and like our videos for updates.
For how long have we been fighting for this electoral reform? I sat in there at the public hearing.
Absolutely.
Where the Senate president came out and stood and said we should take his words. And we know now that his words mean
nothing.
The Senate president, Ahmad Lawan, should be absolutely ashamed of himself. Absolutely ashamed of himself. A man who stood and looked Nigerians in the face and said to us, we should take his word. And I will never forget Esther was in that meeting. Today Esther is late. And how many months after, from December, he said the first quarter they were going to pass the electoral bill. The electoral bill that the people want, not the electoral bill that they want. And here we are up to today. We are now in July and we are still asking for the same thing. What is Betemiala? What was he fighting to be speaker for? He was fighting to be speaker to come and beat this a rubber stamp, doing nothing, not fighting for the people, just sitting there not knowing that he's the number four in this country and playing second fiddle and playing as if he's not a citizen, he's a slave. It can't happen.
It can't happen.
We are saying this is a democracy. And the legislative arm of government is what makes it a democracy. And today we are demanding that transmission of results must be done electronically. Allowed to be done electronically. This is the 21st century. We do not have electricity. You are giving us electric car. Yet we have the means to transmit results electronically and you're denying us that right. Why? Are we going back to 1700? This is the 21st century and we have moved on. We want an election that will be done, that will be credible, that will be fair, that will be the will of the people, that will be the mandate of the people, not what they want. And I said to those, for every Nigerian sitting at home thinking this is not your problem, guess what? It is your problem. It is your problem because when you're looking for that money to take your child to hospital because you do not have money, bad governors isn't giving you a good healthcare system. Bad governors has denied you good quality education. The roads you're traveling, we don't have 24/7 electricity. Foods are very expensive. It's all about bad governors. And how do we get rid of bad governors? It's by voting with candidates with competence, character, capacity, courage, empathy. And we cannot do that if we do not have the right electoral bill. We're not asking for too much.
It's not too much.
We are saying that allow credible elections. Give us good electoral bill. Let us know that whoever gets into office is actually have the will of the people, have the mandate of the people, nothing else. And I call on this 9th National Assembly. You have been infamous. You have been infamous. It is time for you, for even if you are known for one thing, nobody is 100% bad. Even if you are known for one thing, give Nigerians a credible electoral bill. So that whenever we talk about election in this country, whenever we have good, credible election in this country, we will remember the 9th Assembly and forget all of those things, all of those atrocities they've mentioned us on the people.
Right here,
Lawan Agbajamiala, you're the heads of the National Assembly. Be heads. Stop being tails. The legislative arm of government is an arm on its own. There is suppression of power. There is independence. Stop following. Stop being boy. Me, I told you one man. We don't have to understand.
Yes, ma'am.
My brother, I'll be deputy speaker.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's see the other. I'm not
again.
You can't tell you get one. You can't do boy follow Percy. see. You dey go there, go need them. Which ones now? You shall say you come back home, now you come to say you come Abuja, come to do we are not known for that. At the end of the day, this country belongs to all of us. And no Nigerian is more Nigerian than any Nigerian. No matter whether you are in the executive, you are in the legislative arm or the judiciary, we must fight for a greater Nigeria. So that 100 years from now, the Nigerians that will be here will remember this moment and said, all of us, we did good.
And I remember Anex. I remember Jegao. When I remember, I can't remember Oshun.
We all know today that Nigeria cannot afford to have a bad election in 2023.
If we make
the mistake of having bad elections in 2023, it will feed into agitation, and Nigeria will boil over.
Absolutely.
And nobody here can determine what is going to be the outcome and the fate of this nation after the 2023 election if it is rigged. The reason why we are here today is not just only a service to our fatherland, it's a service to every common people in Africa and beyond. Because a destabilized Nigeria is not healthy for Africa and humanity. In order to avert disaster, we are saying you must give the people a path to hope, a path to think. You must allow the people to think that their vote will count and their thumb is important. You must allow the people to know that when they register, they can vote freely, credibly, and transparently. Greatest Nigerian people.
Great.
Greatest Nigerian people.
Great.
We have come here today to appeal to this National Assembly. We have come here today to tell the Senate President, who failed to pass this bill by his own promise. We have come to tell Mr. Femi Gbajabiamila, who also promised that this bill was going to be passed. We want to tell them that this National Assembly will outlive them. But are they ready to leave a lasting legacy in this National Assembly? What is painful about Femi Gbajabiamila and Dr. Ahmed Lawan is this. For years, they sought to be Senate President and Speaker. They didn't get it, and we saw the struggle that happened. But today, the 9th National Assembly, I've given them the leadership of these two hallowed chambers to preside over the affairs of Nigerians. But all they do is not only to be a rubber stamp National Assembly, but also to conduct themselves in a manner that threatens the stability and the welfare of our nation. Simply because we are unable to have good elections, it will undermine the sovereignty of this nation.
Under the previous government, card reader was used, it was electronically done, so there must be backing for electronic voting in the country. Results were communicated electronically under the previous government. The former president, President Goodluck Jonathan, even could not vote initially at Otueke, but subsequently voted. So I don't see what is the issue here. If progress were made under Professor Taiwo Jega, I don't see why we cannot develop on those progress. So INEC is doing a fantastic thing now by ensuring electronic registration of voters. So why will the National Assembly now take INEC back? So we'll lose the gains that have been proposed by INEC. INEC is ready. INEC is ready. INEC did it in Edo. INEC did it in Ondo.
Yes, sir.
And even Nasarawa by election. So if INEC is ready, why don't we support INEC? Is it not the same government?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
If they are supported, yes. Wouldn't the president or the Buhari government, wouldn't they take credit for the gains that we have witnessed? Jonathan is still taking gains. Jonathan is going up and down Africa, lecturing on democracy. He's still taking gains from the electoral advancement that his administration recorded. So it's a win-win situation for the president and the government.
Yes, sir.
So I appeal to the government of the day,
yes, sir,
to give us electronic transmission of results, to put the cap on election spending so that political parties don't just spend recklessly.
Yes, General.
We've been at the National Assembly for the past 1 hour now, and the protest is still on. You can see at the background behind me, they started the protest. This is occupying as well. They've been doing it for the past 5 months now. Now, they got this wind of information, of course. The media reports that subsection 50, I mean section 50, subsection 2 of the Electoral Act 2010 Amendment Bill is being, there are some sections that are being smuggled in, probably alleged forgery. Now, the protesters that we have, Aisha Yesufu, Deji Adeyanju, and host of other CSOs, about 42 CSOs under access, are here to protest with them. And now beside me, at the right, my right hand side, I have Mr. Obani, who is the Executive Director of Fixed Nigerian Politics. Mr. Obani, you too, you came to the National Assembly. What's your mission here? Is it about the forgery or of the electoral act?
Yes, that's the issue of the day, and that's why we're here. We've just left the office of the Deputy Senate President, where we've submitted our protest letter with respect to the forgeries that occurred in the electoral bill.
Okay. So with all so far, what is expectation? Because we heard the Senate President said probably they'll pass this act, which we know they failed twice to do that. Mm-hmm. What's your submission on this?
We believe very strongly, those of us from Fixed Politics, we believe strongly that the Senate will listen to the voice of the people. Don't forget that legislators are representatives of the people. That is the heart of democracy. And they understand very clearly that the provisions which is causing all this furore, which they have inserted into the electoral bill.
Sorry to cut it. Could you just look straight to the camera, please?
Okay. The provisions which they have put into the electoral bill were not given to them by the people of Nigeria. We didn't ask for it. We didn't canvass for it. These are things that we are smuggling into the electoral bill in the cover of the night. And so we are saying very clearly as citizens that they should remove this provisions that they have put in the electoral act so that we can make progress in this country.
Thank you very much, Mr. Right. Anthony Obani. And now, let me talk to Mr. Ariyo. Where is he? Okay. Thank you very much. You are one of part of the struggle. And of course, we've come here for the past 6 months.
6 months, absolutely.
I think this will be more than 10 times we've come here.
Absolutely. Every week, day in, day out, we've been here.
I would just want to ask about the alleged forgery.
Well, Funke, let me say that it's sad, it's unfortunate that it has gotten to this level. Before we have been coming here to tell them to expressly insert the provision for electronic transmission of results. But what we currently have now is that it has gone from bad to worse, and we are not praying for the worst. This bill has now been doctored, and we want to commend those people who help us to know that this bill has been doctored. So in addition to addressing this problem, they also have to also investigate to know those who are behind the doctoring of this bill. And we want to say that what Nigerians are demanding for is electronic transmission of results, including those other sections that have been tampered with, doctored, forged. We want them to be reversed and straightened. In line with the public hearing that was conducted on December 9, 2020, because Nigerians were very emphatic about what we wanted. We want free, fair, credible, and transparent elections, election that will speak to electoral integrity, election in which Nigerians will not be disenfranchised, elections in which people will, you know, we have the right, the franchise, to elect the leaders that they ever, you know, want. And also let us say this, at a time when this nation is suffering from agitation, this 9th National Assembly should be doing everything to endear Nigerians, the Nigerians who want to go away, to tell them that Nigeria is good. Don't go to Biafra, can be part of the Nigerian dream. Oduduwa can be part of the Nigerian dream. You do not need to break away from this nation. This is what this National Assembly should do. And the only way to do that is to tell those people who want to go to Oduduwa, they want to go to Biafra, that you always have the right to elect your leaders freely without encumbrances. And that's exactly what we are begging them for. What they are doing is a threat to national security. It's a threat to the collective existence.
Let me just cut in here. They are the lawmakers. Don't you think they have the right to eject and reject?
They don't have the right to eject, and so we must correct that. When you look at section 14, I think subsection 2, the National Assembly exists, you know, based on the trust of Nigerians. The Constitution says that sovereignty resides with the people of Federal Republic of Nigeria. So the National Assembly is not the Alpha and the Omega here. The sovereignty belongs to Nigerians, so the National Assembly can only write acts based on the dictate of Nigerians. And that is why, in the wisdom of those who put together a legislative system, there will always be a public hearing. It is during the public hearing that people will come and bring what they think is in the best interest, including sending some of these memos to their representative individually. And that's exactly what we've done. The National Assembly does not exist on its own. He exists on behalf of the people of Federal Republic of Nigeria. And that must be stated clearly. Therefore, we are not saying they are garbage in, garbage out. But what we are saying is that they are only elected to do the will of those who are paying their salaries and those who are paying their bills and those who have made it possible for them to be here.